Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Tonek, welcome back on this channel. It's been a while since we worked on this project. To be honest, I kind of lack motivation to build on it. But recently, actually this week, I've got some inspiration and I'm full on back working on it. So yeah, I'm redoing kind of all the scenes again, actually. I kind of figured out that the lighting I did wasn't good enough. Some scenery pieces weren't good enough, so I'm really changing up the ride once again to get a perfect result. I actually started with some characters for Symbolic as well, some new characters. So that's nice. I kind of wanted it to be modeled in Blender, but that didn't really happen, so I just decided to do it on my own, and it turned out pretty well. Perhaps you'll see some footage on it in the next episode. But yeah, this video is mainly trigger work. It's not really that interesting to watch, but I just wanted to let you guys know that I am back with building on Symbolica, so just to give you guys a heads up. I'm kind of, I would say we're halfway there, I think. I'm happy with the ride as it is right now, but it should be a lot better. I got some of the pieces that I made in previous episodes. I deleted them and redid those, especially with the outdoor queue line, just to reduce some piece count, some unnecessary pieces, because I think at the outside the pavilions were like 8 or 10k pieces for a single one of them, so that's 20k pieces, that's nuts. So I reduced that, and I think they're now 2k or something each individual piece, and that helps with the performance as well. So I'm removing all the unnecessary things and replacing them, so that's gonna be looking better and boosting your performance if you wanna try out Symbolica yourself. I also did some custom audio files. I found somebody who was really helpful to get some of his own ride footage and give it to me. So that's really helpful, so that the audio is even better, because Symbolica is updating here and there each and every month, still tweaking it a little bit. So I wanted to get it to the latest version they have right now, and that's happening. So that's really excited. I kind of, like I said, I kind of found new inspiration. I don't know where it's coming from. As you see me right now working on the Botanicum scene that we made. I'm completely redoing this as well. I already redid this, and the result is, I'm gonna say, yeah, it's pretty awesome. It's a bit different than the real life one, but of course it's Planet Coaster. But I tried to recreate it as best as I could, and the result is way better than just a billboard screen, like I did in the previous version of Symbolica. So yeah, I'm happy about it, you can say that. Mainly in this video, as I said, doing trigger work, thought it would be interesting to show you how much work I put into this, for every single scene, to make the lights go smoothly. I'm using colored billboards as well, or colored panels. I don't know if you're gonna see it in this episode, I'm not too sure about that, but it was a shit ton of work, but the result is amazing. And yeah, like I said, I just wanted to let you guys know how much work I put into this, because it is a shit ton of work, but I'm happy, you know. It's not the most interesting work, but it kind of keeps me busy. I've joined I'm more active in the Discord right now. It's Planet X. It's an amazing Discord, some cool guys over there. So yeah, mainly talk to them while I'm doing this stuff. So yeah, just to give it a time a bit, because it is very time consuming to do all this stuff. So yeah, I also used this triggered speakers, because that the sound of the triggered speakers is a bit different than just using the display speakers for the display sequencer. So I'm working with those, and the sound is less, so that actually the sound that I'm using for each scene stays in that scene, and not And the reason behind it is just because if you're in the queue line, I don't want you to hear the scene from the final scene or something like that of the observatory scene, because that is the case right now. So I'm doing it with triggered speakers, and it sort of works nice. It's a bit glitchy from time to time, and so I have to change, might have to change some of it. Also, what you're seeing right now, I redid the entire front facade because it was a bit yellowish, and I looked at the picture of Symbolica, or the front facade of Symbolica, and I changed that up. So yeah, I had to select once again each and every individual piece, and those were a lot of pieces. But the result came out great. It looks even better right now. It's just a yellowish. It's something from the previous Symbolica I made, so that's why I'm changing it up. I wanted to look more natural, more like the real life color, instead of this SpongeBob SquarePants color, as I like to say it myself. But yeah, I think overall, the progress that I'm making these couple of days, it's really impressive. I just found some bits of time, still a bit busy with my study as well. But here and there I got some time left, especially in the afternoon and some bits in the evening. It's kind of a busy busy phase of my life, as I would say, but I'm enjoying every single part of it. Yeah, you see, mainly just recoloring, getting the exact color of the real life Symbolica. It's a bit tricky, and it took I think just 3 to 4 hours. That's how much time I spent into Symbolica to get every single detail right. So this is supposed to be, you know, the best Symbolica dark ride that's ever been made on the workshop. Highly detailed, and yeah, just overall good scenery. And that's I'm really pushing myself into it. I'm doing a lot of effort, you know, I'm putting a lot of effort into this, and the result already is coming out great. Couldn't have been happier with it. And I noticed that a couple of months ago I started this project, and I am still evolving in my Planet Coaster building style. Patience is key with this game, especially if my game crashes, which kind of happened 2 times already. Kind of mad about it, but luckily we have the autosave function, of course. But coming up at the end of the episode, be sure to subscribe, of course, and check out my other channels as well. I post something, some of the progress stuff that you won't be able to see in the YouTube videos on Twitter. Some of the behind the scenes of Symbolica, or just small little updates that are gonna be in a video a couple of days later. So if you want to check out that, be sure to drop a follow me on Twitter. And yeah, as well, I hope you just subscribe and like this video and share it with your friends. It's going to be the best ever dark ride you're going to see in your life. So yeah, without further ado, I will see you guys in the next episode. And yeah, bye now.